On March 11, 2011, a strong earthquake and tsunami triggered the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear disaster. This led to the evacuation of around 154,000 people from the 20-kilometer radius evacuation zone. And on August 24, 2011, the Nuclear Safety Commission of Japan reported that 130 petabecquerels of iodine-131 and 11 petabecquerels of cesium-137 were released in the air between March 11 and April 5. Take a look at this table just to give you an idea of the health risks that radiation exposure can do. The maximum radiation levels recorded at the Fukushima plant was 400 millisieverts an hour. Even though the values were high and the disaster was scary, it still pales in comparison to the Chernobyl nuclear power plant accident. So the question now is, what happens to the radioactive isotopes after 10, 30, and 50 years? This can be answered by using the half-life values of the radioactive elements and the half-life formula, which is essentially a decay function. Now, the half-life is defined as the time it takes for a radioactive substance to decay into half of its original amount. Cesium-137 has a half-life of 30.17 years. And iodine-131 has a half-life of only 8 days. But before we start substituting values into the equation, let's agree to use years as the unit for time. This would make the half-life of iodine-131 as 0.0219 years. Let's now assemble our half-life equations for the radioactive elements using the reported initial amount and their half-life values. So how much radioactive elements remain after 10 years? Let's use the value for T equal to 10 years and substitute it in the half-life equations. For cesium-137, 8.74 petabecquerels will remain and pollute the environment. For iodine-131, however, there would practically be zero left after 10 years because of how fast its half-life is. In total, this is around 6.2% of the initial values. Let's proceed by computing the amount of cesium-137 remaining after 30 and 50 years. After 30 years, 5.52 petabecquerels would remain, which means that the off-limits zone will get smaller, and some of the evacuees can probably live at their old homes since only 3.91% of the original radioactive materials remain. After half a century, 3.49 petabecquerels of radioactive cesium-137 would still be a hazard to people living near the Fukushima nuclear plant, but at least the danger radius would become smaller again. This is around 2.48% of the initial amount of radioactive isotopes. That being said, although some parts can be habitable again, there will most likely be a lot of stigma involved in going back to the ghost towns surrounding the Fukushima power plant, especially since a huge bulk of cesium-137 is still present in the area and will remain there for several decades if no organized decontamination process is done. If it were you, are you willing to go back after several decades? By the way, Be sure to like this video and subscribe to Teach Me Animated Math. I hope you learned a lot about the Fukushima nuclear plant incident and the half-lives of radioactive materials involved. So, I'll see you in the next video!